By the way, worked on place with each dog for about 10 minutes last night. They did amazing. I was proud of them and myself and how quickly they caught on. I couldn't be any happier with them.
Good. So what you're going to do is you're going to turn that into a lifestyle. So imagine this. You're in the bedroom and you say you want your dogs in the bedroom on the floor. You walk in, your dogs are just going to automatically go there. You're in the living room. You sit down on the couch to read a book. Dogs just organically start going there. It's going to become the default lifestyle command. Now, we don't talk much about exercise. I'm a humongous advocate of exercise. Huge advocate of exercise. Proper nutrition. I feed raw. You don't have to feed raw. But if anybody's interested in feeding raw, there's a wonderful book by Thomas Sandberg, Dr. Thomas Sandberg, and it's on our shop. And I hate to plug things that cost money on the show, like our Skypes and then buying stuff, but it's on our shop. If you go to SallyCanineTraining.com/shop, it's a good guide to raw eating. And there's a lot of information there on medical issues as well. And a lot of these medical issues are actually being made worse by some of your commercial grade foods and can be made better through some of the stuff that Dr. Sandberg comes up with next. Going live. Now we're live. Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training and Joelle. Up. Let me turn down my volume. How's everyone going? Happy Saturday night, right? Say Saturday? Is it really Saturday?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Happy Saturday night. You went to the gym tonight, huh? Mm-hmm. I fucking missed it. Well, weekends I'm in.
The roads are so bad, right? So listen to this. You know that road, the first right you make? Not coming out of the gym, but the first right at the light.
Yes, correct. Yes.
Some guy comes flying out.
That's a curve.
On the curve, freaking spins, nope. Does like a 180, nope. And meanwhile, literally like
you're there,
10 feet in front of me.
Just waiting for to get hit by a car.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the scariest fucking moment.
Yeah.
Because you put your foot on the brake, and you're like, it's just going to happen.
I'm a sitting duck.
Yes. It's like, I can't do anything.
I'm like, who does that? Like, meanwhile, there's no cars behind me. He had to rush out to cut me off.
I know.
Like, you couldn't have just waited?
I know. Anyway, hey, everybody, other than car talk, this is clicking clack with car talk.
The roads are really bad tonight.
Yeah. So anybody out in Providence, Rhode Island, or New England, be really careful driving tonight. Anyway, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and this is the fantastic Joelle. We do a show 3 times a week, every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday night. Next week, we're doing it Thursday night because Wednesday night we do an awesome reactive dog class. Really, really, really good. You did a great job with that one, showing some great spatial pressure. I'm really proud of you. Again, getting yourself out there was really, really good. And we might only do an hour because we're a lot of stuff's going on that we need to get done tonight. So, like, we didn't finish a couple of tasks. And I'd like to get 3 hours sleep tonight. So it's like... Our day has just begun, even though Literally. It's the end of the day, sort of. Like, the day has just begun. So anybody, so we do the What Would Jeff Do show. It's a triage show. You all ask, how do you stop a behavior? And I tell you how to, and that's with the proper application of punishment. We do something called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Guys, Jeff Gellman Seminars. Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars. Find a town by you. Buy a ticket. The locations are not listed, but the cities are listed. Their seminars are happening. Go there. But unfortunately, we've had to hide the seminars because people are harassing everybody. People are harassing our fans. People are.
I know.
It's so terrible. It's so terrible what's going on right there. And Megan, what's Megan's last name over in the UK?
The Royal Megan?
Markle?
Meghan Markle.
Meghan, I'm sorry for bumping you off the front page. I feel really, really bad.
She's trying to get out of the media right now, right?
Maybe she should be thanking me.
I'm sorry.
Okay, Meghan, I'm sorry, but you're welcome, you know? So anything else I can do to help? Yeah, just ring me up. I'm easy to get a hold of because just send me hate mail. I'll get it, you know? It's the easiest way to get a hold of me these days is to send me hate mail. We get those. And the Jeff Gellman seminars, what those are is, again, those are problem-solving seminars. My seminars, which you're seeing all these videos from, which are our videos, ironically, you can really go to YouTube. We have a wonderful video pinned up right on our featured video of, like, full explanation of bonking. Mm-hmm. Whether you agree with it or not, it's not the point. It's like, it's right there. There are videos. They're not hidden cameras. You actually can photograph and people videotape at our seminars. It's not like we confiscate cameras. It's not like there's like some little peephole camera in someone's buttonhole. And this, like the CIA does that, you know? So what happens is those are, again, I can't wait to get to the seminar so Jeff can finally stop this behavior. Leash reactivity, human aggression, dog aggression, massive separation anxiety, selective listening. Now, when I say the word fix, that means we do a really great step one, and then we give people instructions on how to do step two. For anybody that wants to also know, we do 95% positive reinforcement training in our company. Clickers and food. And that's where we are at the training center. People know me for step one. Why? Nobody's showing it. But the step one is you need to stop the unwanted behavior. Then you start training what you want, whether it's through obedience work or counter conditioning. But you've got to stop it. You've got to just stop it cold, stop it now. And that's what we do. So we'll talk a lot about that. And then there's something called Top Chat.
Bottom right
corner, there's something called Top Chat. And if you click on that, click on your Top Chat. Make sure we have sound. To click on your Top Chat, you don't have to pay to play. We answer all questions or as many as we can, depending if I go on any rants, and you know me. But people like to throw us a little bit of cash, number one, to just show your appreciation for over the years of free content, to get their question at the top to make sure it gets answered. Anyway, let's jump right into it.
All right, Gretchen. Hey guys, damn beautiful, Joelle.
That must be Gretchen. Gretchen, you don't even have to put your name up there. Like that's your catchphrase. Put it on a T-shirt, Gretchen.
Skincare queen. Hey guys, hope all is well. Can you have multiple places in the house? For example, we have a couple beds scattered in the home. When I want them to go to their bed, do I use place for every bed?
Skincare queen, I think you're new.
She is, and she wrote us this fabulous email.
Holy fucking shit.
Yeah, that's her.
Look at you. We're like one piece of paper away from you, skincare queen. Yeah. Look. Skincare queen, I'm hugging you. Right now, I'm hugging you. That's as far as we're going.
Was so nice, though.
We're not going to second base, skincare queen. That was really nice of you. So thank you. Everyone sees all the hate. We've gotten so much wonderful comments from the people that actually use us, whether they use us virtually or they've used us in person. So thank you so much. Also, you're going to start seeing a little bit of a different flavor. After 15 years, I'm changing the flavor of our social media. Maybe one out of six or one out of seven, you're going to see a negative comment that somebody wrote us. And those are mostly going to be because people are threatening the lives of my children. And with no remorse whatsoever. They're literally justifying it. So it's like, okay, well, I've got to get it out there because people really need to know and see how bad it is. And maybe people will think twice. Maybe. Or like, so I should kill you, Jeff, and your kids. It's like, please stop with kill you, Jeff. Like, stop right there. Please stop right there. Anyway, so enough about that. And let's get right to the questions.
Doodle doggy breed. Love taking my dogs on hikes.
Oh, hold on. We never answered a question. Skincare queen. Yes. Place is place. Have multiple ones around the house, but obviously give a little bit of a like place. So if you walk in the bedroom and you have a place, place. If you're walking in the living room and you've got a place, place. You do that. Yes.
Doodle doggy breed. Love taking my dogs on hikes. Too bad national parks don't allow dogs. Thanks to failing positive only training.
Yeah, well, it's not only thanks to failing only positive training. There's probably a lot of different reasons why. And you know, the cool thing about that is you get enough people together to organize. You probably can overturn that if you want to. You can't even have them on leash.
No.
You can't have dogs in national parks at all.
No. Because of poop and stuff. People not picking up dog shit.
But they allow horses.
Maybe because horse shit is just, hey, it doesn't have preservatives and shit like dog food.
Oh.
I don't know. Well, I'm just like speculating.
Well, it's bigger.
Yeah, but it probably just like decomposes maybe. I don't know.
All I know is this. When I was on the John Muir Trail, which is a photo that I put up a long time, like literally this week. When I was on the John Muir Trail, they only issue certain amount of passes per day that you can start.
Right.
So you can make a reservation or you can do standby. So we did standby. We slept overnight in our cars. They got bear boxes all around. Like you can't even leave a candy wrapper in your car or a bear will literally smash your window. It's like really, it's pretty freaky.
My God.
Oh yeah, they go nuts there. And I'm like, you limit the amount of people. And I know why they're doing it. They're doing it because they don't want the soil to erode and erosion and things like that. But it's like, you guys have like 20 horse caravans like going up and down these trails. Like shitting, pissing, hooving, walking, weight.
Hooving.
And I'm like, that does a lot more damage than like 20 people, 40 people, 100 people. Yeah, did I tell you the story about the stampede? We almost got crushed by a stampede of horses. Anyway, next.
CR, what's a good response to, oh, do they bite when I'm walking my dogs? Like, I don't know how to answer that, LOL. So annoying.
So you can say, not only do, I said, of course they bite, they've got parvo. Next.
Michelle, you guys aren't even on yet and already four thumbs down. Life's too short for the hate to consume. Oh, yeah,
we're up to eight. You know, it's like this. Listen, thumbs down or thumbs up, it's called engagement. It's called engagement. I'm okay with it. This is the thing about me. And I think you're okay. You're getting there too. You know, like if you don't like me, I'm okay about that. I really, really am. But can you be civil? And I think we've lost that. We've lost that. I had a very civil discussion with a wonderful wildlife photographer at 3 o'clock in the morning.
I saw that conversation.
And it's like, we disagree.
I tried.
Yep.
It didn't go well.
You know.
I tried with a few people.
We disagree, but it was respectful.
Mm-hmm.
And he's from Ireland. And I forgot his name, or I would give you a shout out now, not that you're watching the show, but maybe you are. And, you know, and we disagree, but it was civil.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, that's called a rational human being. You can disagree. So next.
Yep. Life FX, is an e-collar a good tool to train any breed of dog?
Yeah, so you can use an e-collar for anything. You can use an e-collar for close proximity, far distance, state of mind, to train an obedience command, and to stop an unwanted behavior with or with massive amounts of distractions. So just think about all of those components. That's why we like remote collars. This concept that you're putting a remote collar on a dog and pushing a button and the dog's gonna all of a sudden do something is the biggest falsehood out there is. Other than getting off of a counter, getting into a trash can, getting into the litter box, fence fighting, eating poop, digging holes. That, you don't need any sort of like training. You just make those things suck. And then organically the dog's like, why would I keep getting on the counter if that sucked? But on the flip side, dogs do go through underground fencing on purpose.
To go play with dogs.
Right, exactly.
Karen says, thanks, Melissa. Gretchen, Jeff, do you think service dogs bred and raised for the job would wash less if they allowed puppy raisers to use correction?
Oh my God, yes. Not even correction collars. Corrections. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I know of a bunch of colleagues of mine who do service dog training who the dog's 18 months old. Just hits maturity. It's had a year and a half of training. It's with the end user.
Mm-hmm.
So say it's a diabetic alert dog.
Yep.
It's with the child, say. And it growls at something. They wash the dog sometimes. And I'm like, that could be fixed.
Yeah.
It's sad. All that work. But a good service dog, though, a good service dog company does a balanced approach. They really do. Next.
Jean. Hi, Jean.
Hey, Jean.
Gretchen says, thanks, Melissa. Barista Boy Soccer. Hey, guys. CR, when I do the down command with my dog outside, he doesn't go all the way down. He's like 95% down.
Right, right.
Then I have to repeat myself. Is more reps the answer? Thanks for everything you do. Love you guys.
So, who's that? Is that Barista Boy?
It is. No. That's CR.
Because Barista Boy added another word to his name.
No, it's always been Barista Boy Soccer. I always just say Barista Boy.
But
it's the same Barista Boy.
Oh, I was going to say, it's like...
Where are you a barista? Is it Starbucks?
Okay, so anyway, what I would do is I would add some leash pressure to that. So, repeat down again, a little bit of leash pressure. Mm-hmm. Next.
Skincare Queen. By the way, worked on place with each dog for about 10 minutes last night. They did amazing.
Awesome.
I was proud of them and myself and how quickly they caught on. I couldn't be any happier with them.
Good. So, what you're going to do is you're going to turn that into a lifestyle. So, imagine this. You're in the bedroom, and you say you want your dogs in the bedroom on the floor. You walk in, your dogs are just going to automatically go there. You're in the living room. You sit down on the couch to read a book. dogs just organically start going there. It's going to become the default lifestyle command. Now, we don't talk much about exercise. I'm a humongous advocate of exercise. Huge advocate of exercise. Proper nutrition. I feed raw. You don't have to feed raw. But if anybody's interested in feeding raw, there's a wonderful book by Thomas Sandberg, Dr. Thomas Sandberg, and it's on our shop. And I hate to plug things that cost money on the show, like our Skypes and then buying stuff, but it's on our shop. If you go to SallyCaninetraining.com/shop, it's a good guide to raw eating. And there's a lot of information there on medical issues as well. And a lot of these medical issues are actually being made worse by some of your commercial grade foods and can be made better through some of the stuff that Dr. Sandberg comes up with next.
Karen, Jeff and his team are the best pet dog trainers in the world.
I don't know about that, but thank you. So I've never claimed to be the best dog. I'm not a dog training guru. Like, you know what I mean? All I know is we are really good at stopping unwanted behaviors, and I'm farthest from the biggest, because I mean, there's people out there. Every once in a while, you'll see one of these people. It's like, I can't believe he's got 90,000 followers on YouTube. I'm like, 90,000? That's not a lot. Mm-hmm. Like, a million? Now we're talking about some numbers.
Right.
You know what I mean? Now we can start talking about, like, a following. 90,000? That's actually not a lot. I mean, I've got colleagues that have got a quarter million, mm-hmm. you know? So, and people are surprised. It's like, why are you surprised? I've been doing this for 15 years. If anything, I'm doing a crappy job on YouTube. It's like, I'm not getting enough. I'm not getting enough. Next.
Gretchen said, you said it, Karen. They're the best. Katie, hi, J&J. My dog isn't allowed to go out unless it's for the bathroom. He injured both his front paws on some glass. He's high energy. Any ideas how I can keep him entertained?
Oh, fuck. That sucks. So after my dog had ACL surgery, I kept girl like 6 weeks on a leash, potty only. And then I eased her back into swimming. And I did all of her exercise to swimming. So what I would do is, I don't know what, that's a doctor question, like what's your dog's limitations? But if you can find water therapy, that's really, really good. I'm not sure what climate you live in. Walking slow, treadmill slow, things like that. Maybe do some scent work, Next.
Kibu. Hi, Joelle and Jeff. Wendy and Kibu from Vancouver.
Hey.
Wednesday and Thursday snow days is now beginning to wash away with the rain.
Oh, good. Yeah, it could be messy, huh? Mm. We were getting snow tonight. And then tomorrow's supposed to be like in the 40s, so that means it's probably going to be gone, yeah. Which is good, less shoveling for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Michelle. Hi, guys. Hi, haters lurking in the back. We love you anyway.
Yeah. So we actually don't get a lot of haters on the show, and which is fine. I think, you know, a lot of the people, they hate from afar, and there's always, you know, a couple of them out there. And this is the thing. It's like, for all the people that don't like me, I mean, even for some of the vile stuff, I mean, I have empathy. I mean, it's sort of hard to say that. And I'm really, I think this week I've been really digging. How have you been doing on personal development this week? You're challenged, aren't you? Okay, you're challenged. Okay, so.
I just think, though, like, and somebody who I was going, not a hater, a friend, actually. Yeah. It's like, anyone who says this stuff, like, hates themselves.
Yeah. Like. Yeah, yeah.
And then that puts it in a perspective. It's like, yeah. Anyone who's, yeah. like, who goes out of their way to do this shit, it's like,
yeah.
you're miserable.
Yeah.
And I do. I feel yeah. bad for you.
And I do. And I really do. And you know what? One thing I thought of, actually, Melissa reminded me about this, is until someone has been in the same situation as the people that come to our seminars, they'll just never understand.
They won't.
It's sort of like me. I've never been in a wheelchair before. Mm-hmm. I've never been in a wheelchair before. And so I do respect and am an advocate for handicapped accessible places, but I will never fully understand. I can hear my haters now saying, well, we can fix that for you, Jeff. You know, but I can never fully understand the struggle that somebody that's in a wheelchair has. Because I haven't experienced it.
Right.
I haven't experienced it. I think, so there's people out there, like there's a couple of people out there that, not a couple, a lot of people out there that say, in no situation should you ever hit your dog. Ever. And I said, really? No situation? Ever? Like, ever. I can think of a bunch. Like,
Dog's going after our kid?
Your personal dog is biting your kid. What would you do? I would hope you would do anything possible to save your child, which would probably involve hitting and kicking, right? I mean, you're like, your child's being bit. How about an off-leash dog attacks your dog? What would you do? I wouldn't hit it. I would just shoot it. Okay. Well, I guess you're right. I guess you're right.
I'll just kill it.
I guess you're right. You didn't hit it, you know. But the point is, it's like ever though, ever. It's like, no. I said, until you've dealt with a dog with some serious behavioral issues, I think it's hard to have understanding of the work we do. That's for sure. Even an experienced dog trainer that maybe be in, like, say, the sport dog world or the agility world, things that we don't do. But when you work in the pet dog world, you work with a lot of dogs that are, like, really nervous and fearful. None of those dogs would ever exist in that world.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't know how to deal with that stuff. And doesn't mean they're not a good dog trainer. They're probably excellent dog trainers at what they do. But these are different dogs. It's literally a different dog. It's like, why do you think they have special needs teachers?
Right.
That's actually might be good. It's like, this is a special needs teacher. You can have some of the best teachers out. Here we go. You have some of the best teachers out there, but they don't have experience teaching deaf children.
Mm-hmm.
That takes a special kind of teacher.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Yeah.
No shit.
Yeah, I know, but I'm saying it's like they. There's a lot of rationalizations and comparisons here. Next.
Rational.
I know. I'm being rational. Sorry. I'm a rational person. Next.
All right. Let's get through the questions, please. Okay. Enough. Melissa says hello.
Hey, Melissa.
Michelle says good evening, Jeff, to all and all.
Hello.
Sarah Bug R says hey, everyone.
Hey, everyone.
Kibu says love you guys.
Kibu, we love you too.
She Wolf says good evening, J&J.
She Wolf, I love you too.
All right, Sarah Bug. Hey, Jeff. I have an 18-week-old puppy who hates being left alone in the crate.
Yes.
I bonked the crate. It seemed to work the first time, but he started barking and whining again.
Yes.
And it has not worked since. I'm sleeping in the same room as him. Ah. He will not stop all night, and my dad has to be able to work.
Okay, so this is what you're going to do. This goes against everything your heart tells you and what everyone else is going to tell you. 18 weeks old. Okay. Structured bathroom. Structured feeding. Structured water. I want you to take it out 2 to 3 times prior to bedtime. Bedtime is at 10 o'clock. Put a slip lead on the dog. Go outside at 9:30 to the exact same potty spot. Go potty. Don't walk around. Go potty. The dog potties. Click. Give a small morsel of food reward. Bring the dog back in. 9:45. Do it again. 10 o'clock. Do it again. 3 times you went out to the same potty spot and the dog went to the bathroom. Boom, you're done. The dog has definitely emptied its bladder, hopefully, and hopefully emptied its bowels. So, next thing you know, dog goes in the crate, whining. What is it? It's separation issues. Unfortunately, your heart is saying to sleep in the room, but what you are doing, no fault of yours, but what you are doing is you are reinforcing that, oh, if I cry, my owner sleeps in my room. And I'm not against dogs sleeping in bedrooms, but what I'm against is creating a separation anxiety dog, because then it's going to be a shit show later in life. So what we do is, this sounds like, oh my God, that sounds so mean, but it works. So whining in a crate, you don't need to know the root cause. All you need to know is it's annoying. So what do? Walk up to the crate. Always say no before you apply any punisher. Always say no. Historically, some I don't like eating poop. I usually don't say no. I say bon appetit. So what you're gonna do is, and then I take out my meat tenderizer, right? So what you're gonna do is, you're gonna say no. Hit the top of the crate. All the information you hear out there that says you're gonna create a negative association with a crate is false. I'm not seeing that. We're not seeing that. We do it. We stop separation anxiety in less than a day. So hit the top of the crate. Hit the side of the crate. Earthquake. Shake the crate. Bonk the crate. So you can do that. At 18 weeks old, you can actually have a remote collar on the dog. And it's not like you're dialing it up and blasting your dog. It's the last thing I want anybody to do. But you can actually find that magic level that tells your dog, you know what? Crying, it's not the most comfortable thing to do. And your dog, what does it do? Lies down and goes to sleep. It doesn't shut down. You don't lose trust. okay? It's not be this concept that was like, oh my gosh, it's your best friend. You should never do that. No, it's keeping you, your dad, it's keeping your dad up at night. If you don't stop this, the dog goes. You know that. So, next.
Gretchen, every time I hear tires screech or horns honking, my heart stops. It scares me.
Okay. You might Gretchen, talk to somebody about that. Next.
I don't know who I am. Hey, I don't know if you deal with small dogs very much.
Of course.
I have a Maltipoo who tries to attack my six-month-old shepherd yep. when he's at the house.
Yep.
He wags his tail and growls, high-pitched barks. Help.
Okay. Now, I'm not there. Don't send me a video. But that could be an invitation to play. It might not be. It might be, I'm going to kick your ass today. But it might be an invitation to play. That's how dogs communicate. Next.
Sarah Bug Art, I already read that. Kibu said, you have stupid drivers too, huh? Oh my God, I think Rhode Island might be the worst state
for driving. Somebody can look this up. No, I don't, not the worst states. But
Florida's pretty bad too.
No, so I do believe the state of Rhode Island tested last in driver law. Like the laws of the road.
Yeah, I could see it.
So
people do some crazy shit every day.
So does that mean stupid? I don't know about that, I said, but I think awareness of the law, which could be simple right of way, I think there's that.
The stop sign here, people blow through that every day. I'll wait like extra long. I'm like, are we sure? I know it's a four-way,
so in Rhode
but I got to be real sure.
If you ever come to Providence, Rhode Island, Providence specifically, red lights and stop signs are suggestions.
Suggestions.
But
they do have traffic cameras everywhere.
It's funny because my folks came here from San Diego and they wanted to walk across. They stayed in the cottage. And you know, there's the A and B market across the street.
Would never walk over there.
Yes. It's like literally across the street.
The intersection.
Yes. And I said to them, there's been a lot of accidents in that intersection.
I believe it.
I can't tell you how many times I've run out there and like, there's a story. Here's a story for you. You ready for this?
This might be an hour and a half show.
No, let's do an hour and a half show, okay? I run outside. I hear it. Okay, it's always somebody hitting a telephone pole.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a pole at each corner, so that statistically it's going to happen. A driver hits the pole, smash. Okay, that's a telephone pole. I run outside, and I hear a lot of screaming about being drunk and about, like, you're crazy, man, you MF, you know, all this stuff. And I'm like, okay. Shit's going to go down. So I grab some pepper spray. Didn't grab my gun. I grab some pepper spray, and I grab one of my dogs, and I get out there. The guy's spinning his wheels, trying to go through the pole. Finally, he puts it in reverse, goes backwards at full speed, smashes into a car, and I'm like, situation.
Oh, no.
Puts it in the drive, drives back into the pole, and I'm like, someone's gonna die. I fling open his door, spray him in the face with pepper spray him in the face with pepper spray, and which I probably should have taken the keys out first, because then I'm going through all this fucking pepper spray, and I'm like, I reach in and I grab his fucking keys out of the engine.
Yeah. Oh my
it's like
God.
This guy's got to be stopped. I mean, he was like, he was gonna kill somebody. He was gonna kill somebody. Yeah, it's like, I don't know what's up with you. And then by that time, there was lots of people around there. I'm like, I'm getting my dog out of there, and I'm not going to deploy my dog, and I'm not going to, like, pull you out of the vehicle. Like, mm-hmm. I don't want that liability. I have no problem spraying you in the face with pepper spray, though. But it's like, and I'm not a violent person, but it's like, it's time for me to back up.
Yeah.
Because there was so many people around that were speaking Spanish to him. He's a Hispanic man. That it's like, okay, you guys are going to definitely have this under control. Yeah. People were furious.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, people were furious.
That's a busy intersection. Yeah. You're endangering a ton of people.
I mean, it was just a matter, like, because people are getting out of their cars, and they're like you're going to get hit by a car. Yeah. Yeah.
It's wild.
But there's been
only in Providence.
There's been so many incidents at that corner.
You just see
So many.
Morgan, my pit used to want to chase every kid. Now she off-leash heels at parks, dies down.
Oh, fuck.
And lies down, stays with kids at the park. I have a dog from a hoarding situation, too, ever since I stopped babying her, and where's the rest? Using a prong and e-collar, her confidence has boosted, and she's 100 times less fearful. Thank you for everything. I hope to see you one of these summers at your shadow program.
Yeah, thank you. Who said that?
Morgan,
I'll be looking out for your application. This is the thing. I get it. I really get the human heart. I mean, I get it. I mean,
I think we've all been there at one point.
Yes, yes. I mean, that's how about a lot of dog trainers got into it because they were there and it didn't work, and then they figured out what worked.
Everyone's got that one.
Yes,
dog.
Exactly. So, unfortunately, more structure, more leadership, more guidance, more accountability. Even the most fearful dog is what it's going to help it. Mm-hmm. And then, when you finally get the dog that you're looking for, then your heart can kick in a little bit more.
Yeah.
But I think it's the beginning. I think it's really important to have that structure. Next.
Yep. Bogdana, Jeff, what is your opinion on hounds in general? I find this breed more challenging in genetics. That nose takes its toll.
I mean, as far as like hounds, like not a greyhound. Forget the greyhound breed right now. But you're more like your scent hound. Or a sight hound. I mean, I'm a pet dog trainer. You know, we do pet dog training here. We stop unwanted behaviors and we train basic behaviors. So, you know, I'm not going to throw that in the difficult dog category. You know, I'm going to throw, you know, not a breed, but your nervous, fearful dogs are your more difficult of dogs. Next.
We got this card in today from Sawyer's owner.
Oh, yeah.
That plot hound.
Yeah, that was a plot hunt. Yeah, one. Yeah. We should post that up. Yep.
Sarah Bug Art. There's a third part to that. She said, "I've tried lots of methods and they don't work. Even tried making the crate a happy place for the whining puppy."
Yeah. So
hold on. There's more.
Oh, sorry.
Four parts. We'll be getting an e-collar.
Who's this, Sarah?
She's new, I think.
All right, Sarah.
I'll be
nice.
I'll be getting an e-collar only for this issue, but I'm able to. Is there anything else you would suggest?
So e-collars are great. This is the thing.
I think you already kind of answered all this. Though.
Yeah. We're done. Next.
Barking Bakers. Dog is great in the yard with owners. If left in dog run, he will dig under or eat the wood fence.
Yep.
Any suggestions to teach dog not to do those things? Dog never does this in front of the owners.
Of course not. There's a separation issue. Yeah, a lot of dogs don't do a lot of things. You know, trust me, in front of my parents, I didn't do, you know, I wasn't doing drugs in front of my parents. So you know, the thing is, it's you can do a couple of things. You can put hot wire. You can put hot wire along the bottom. That'll stop it. Like, that's probably going to be your least expensive thing to do is hot wire. Go to Tractor Supply and run some hot wire. Dog touches it, bounces off. Oh, my God, you're shocking the dog. It's like, guys, if your dog escapes from its pen, and there will always be those people that are like, well, you shouldn't leave your dog outside. It's like, actually, a lot of people leave their dogs outside. A lot of dogs love living outside.
If Wes could be out running around the snow right now, he would be there.
Your dogs could spend 6 to 8 hours minimum outside and love life.
They used to.
Yep, I know.
When I had 2 acres.
Yep, so then there was that damn divorce, you know.
Damn divorce.
Now you're left to concrete parking lot.
Lucky me.
So don't worry, you'll have that back.
City life.
You'll have that back one day. You'll have that back one day. And the cool thing is you'll buy it by yourself, too, which is really cool. I'm proud of you on that one. Bam. You know, what I would do is I would do hot wire. That's going to be your best thing. But your dog escapes. It gets hit by a car. It dies or it runs away. That's a horrible feeling coming home to like an empty kennel. Next.
Yeah. Michelle, finally getting over this insane cold. Temps changing by 50 degrees in 36 hours from negative 40 Celsius to our normal plus 4 Celsius.
Wow.
Took some creativity to keep the 5 dogs busy for those 8 insane days.
Jeez.
Man, it was cold as hell here too.
Yeah, but it wasn't 40 degrees below.
God, no.
I know.
It was like 16 this morning though.
I had 14 on my thermostat.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
14.
Still, you know, we got your car is more modern than mine, so I'll go by yours.
That's mine.
Yeah.
Sarah Bug Art said, "Sorry for having it so spread out. We forgive you."
Yeah, we forgive you. Just don't do a 4-part. You know how you can eliminate that? Don't do 4-part questions anymore.
Oh, hush. Hold on, dog training. Got in tonight at what looks to me is close to feral as I've seen. Any tips on just moving this dog is tragic to her. Frozen, objects, you name it. And that was just to go potty.
I know.
Hiding preferred.
I know. Okay. So when you're using a feral dog, believe it or not, a prong collar is going to be your best friend because your dog will actually, when you work with a truly feral dog, and if you use a slip lead or even a martingale or a flat buckle collar, or a harness they'll escape from. So you have to be really, really careful. So we don't use harnesses to train anyway. But that's going to be your gentlest collar there is. What I would do right now is stick to the basics. Do movements. Don't ask for a sit. Don't ask for a down. Do movements. So like literally like place, that's it. Healing, walking around the yard, do that for now. Everything in movement right now. Next.
Morgan, using a prong and e-collar, her confidence has boosted. Oh, I already read that. Yep. Melissa posted the link to your seminar.
Oh, thank you.
Kibu.
Yep, guys, seminars are still going on. Do them. Yep.
Kibu said, I thought you shared that front page with Harry and Megan.
I did, but I bumped, but they got a smaller picture. They got a smaller picture. So I did. It was Megan and Harry, and I think the day before they had a big picture. So I don't, let me reword that. I didn't bump them off the page. I bumped them out of position. So I do apologize for Megan. But even though I apologize to Megan. Harry too, but I just don't, you know, she's probably more sensitive, but maybe not.
I don't know.
Not because she's a female. It's just because, you know.
Jenny. Hey, you guys. How's it going? I saw all the hate you guys are getting and shake my head. The Choncla Mexican community supports you.
So you haven't seen it all because I think on this round, and I'm not, this is no badge of honor. Trust me, I'd rather not have to deal with this shit. Mm. We're probably up to over 5,000 pieces of hate.
Probably.
5,000 pieces of hate. Easily over 100 death threats. Easily. Easily. I mean, the FBI's file is building. Mm. Yeah. So, people should stop. Mm. They really should stop. Really, please think. Guys, not just with us, but I know you're passionate about a cause. I get it. But you just got to be careful what you put in writing. And then people calling the center and making vile threats to us. It's like your phone number pops up. It gets recorded. It gets archived. It gets like, it's stop. People should stop. People should stop. Next.
Skincare queen. I seriously wish I could afford to come to your guys' seminars. I live in Connecticut, so pretty damn close. But for now, I have your videos and hopefully soon a Skype to prep dogs for baby girl due soon.
Okay, cool.
As long as Jeff can hold the baby.
Yes.
Cause pack. Aloha, J&J. Thanks for your show.
You're welcome.
She-Wolf. Jeff, how do I stop whining and crocodile rolling? My crocodile rolling Great Dane sounds like a deflating balloon tornado. Sorry to hear about the hate. We need more love on this planet. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
Crocodile rolling Great Dane.
Damn, that's a big-ass fucking crocodile roll. So there's a couple of different theories on the crocodile roll. What you can do is wait it out. The first time, wait it out. And then go into movement. Next.
Anna and Alicia, my female Great Dane, who gets overly excited when she sees other dogs and pulls, trying to greet them. She can also be overbearing when playing with another dog, even when they express boundaries.
Yeah. So someone's got to correct the dog. You or another dog. It doesn't sound like the other dogs are doing it, so you've got to do it. So or it also sounds like an arousal issue. So a remote collar will dramatically correct that. It's so funny because this girl, Kirstie Laurie, you know, again, goes on to our page here and bashes us and, you know, get the fuck out of Scotland. And I'm like, guys, like, you don't need to do that. It's unnecessary.
Right.
It's just unnecessary. It's not necessary to do.
Go out of your way.
Go out of your way. There's so many people out there that could use your help. I'm sure there's something that you can help somebody with.
How to be a troll.
No, I mean, seriously. There's something that they can do something with. Next.
T. Mike MC. Thanks, J&J, for all you do. I always recommend y'all for any questions that come up on all the dog sites I'm on.
Oh, thanks.
One big weirdo took my bulldog to the dog park after 5 months of refusing to bring him. He was attacked by a German shepherd and left with a punctured eye. Never again. Oh, my God.
How many times have I said, please stay out of dog parks? Please. Next.
Fuck. Deb. Celebrating a little success with my reactive Basenji with both other dogs and golf carts. Great walk today with very little loading.
Nice.
I was amazed and will keep on working with him. See you in Florida.
Awesome. Yeah, the golf cart thing, correct. It's funny. I once trained a golf cart dog that was hired to chase the geese.
Did it eat poop on the way?
No, it didn't do that. And we turned the golf cart into place.
Nice.
So what I would do is after he's done, I'd send him out to scare the geese, and then I would say, place, and he'd recall back and jump into the golf carts. And he wasn't allowed to move because we had to work while the owners, while the actual, the members were golfing. That's when the geese are out, when the members are out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next.
Sarah Bug R. Also, thank you, Gretchen. You have been awesome in helping me out the past while.
Awesome.
Party. Melissa, I have a Chihuahua and recently rescued a pit bull. Not really by choice. How do I know if they will be okay together? I'm nervous introducing them. No idea if he is okay with other dogs.
So this is the thing. I don't know. I don't know anything about the Chihuahua. And I don't know anything about the pit bull. And it's not because it's a pit bull. Any dogs. How do you introduce any two dogs? There's so many variables. Your skill set. The dog skill set. You recognizing the difference between loading and not loading. Is it play? I mean, I've had people that have misidentified a play bow as aggression. It's like, that's an invitation to play. That's not aggression. So best thing to do is migrate. Boom. But because of the size difference, be really careful. Be really, really careful. Next.
Jan, hey, Jeff and Jolene, my heroes. Hi, Jan.
Next.
Roger, hey, guys. When correcting with an e-collar for breaking or not doing a well-known command, do you correct with no or wrong, and is it high level or medium? Thanks for all the free content.
What's the first part again? When correcting for?
For breaking or not doing a well-known command.
Okay, that's no. That's no. So that's no, and then correction, and the correction is higher level, because that's assuming, as much as I talk about punishment here, we clicker train dogs. A dog learning sit, down, place, recall, even kennel up, doesn't hear the word no until 300 to 500 repetitions. Next.
Rick, I really appreciate your guidance. You've helped so much already.
Oh, you're welcome, Rick. Thanks for being on the show. Appreciate it.
Sarah Bug Art, definitely. I've loved the raw honesty with dogs and dog training. It's really refreshing.
Oh, that's good to know. Thank you. It's great to have you. She's new, isn't she?
She is, yeah.
Yeah, welcome.
I think Gretchen brought her here.
Yeah, welcome to the family. We're getting a lot of new people. Welcome to the family. Mm-hmm. Welcome to the family. I appreciate you. We're on Monday, Wednesdays, and Saturday nights, historically at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You hear a lot about punishment on this show, but that's not all we do. But most people need help stopping unwanted behaviors. Our website and our social media platforms are filled with just a plethora of information. Our YouTube channel has got a lot of great information on it. Next.
Maddie. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Hopped on to help you a bit tonight, Melissa.
Oh.
Happy Saturday chat. Hey, Maddie.
Maddie, I'm trying to get that go to my PC to work. We might have to look for an alternative. Next.
Yeah. Gretchen said, Jeff's one of a kind. Blessing. I'm getting a lab puppy in a few weeks for service work. I have easy access to human socialization. But how would I socialize her to dogs without having friends with well-balanced dogs?
That's the problem. You need to find. Well, a puppy class. Go to a puppy class. I'm not a big fan of the big box trainers, but even a big box store puppy class, it's gonna be okay. I mean, the only thing you have to watch out for is like 2, 3, 4 puppies ganging up on your puppy, and oh god.
I know, I'm tired.
Oh my god, talking about puppies just gets me tired. And it's exhausting work, that's why.
Sure is.
And making sure that they don't gang up on your puppy and if the trainer goes, oh, let them figure it out, it's like, no, you can't have that. Up until 14 weeks, you really don't want to have anything negative, you know, to happen to the dog. It's hard though. It's hard without a balanced pack. So join a puppy socialization class. Next. Yeah.
Blessing said, separate question, any tips for potty training?
I'm not the potty training guy. I'm not good at potty training. Go over to, who's got a good website? It's called Click and Treat. Click and Treat. It's Gary Wilkes. He's got a good, pretty much step-by-step on potty training. Also, jump onto YouTube. There's got to be tons and tons of things. I would encourage you not to use potty pads. Next.
Beast Mode Fitness. My pit bull is very energetic and acts obnoxious when she sees dogs. I took her to the park to walk with e-collar on and corrected her on level 40, and it still would pull and bark. Any tips?
Yeah, tons of tips, Beast Mode. Welcome to the show. So remember, the remote collar isn't directional. The remote collar doesn't say what to do. So in level 40 on a dog that's drivey, and I also don't know the fit of it, so if you had bad fit, it might as well be level 4. Also, once the dog is in drive, a lot of your bully breeds don't care. Like my Malinois can blow through 100 and not care. Meanwhile, I can correct him at single digits when there's no arousal. What I would do is I would fit your dog with a proper prong collar, and try doing the 180 move. And did the video go out about the prepping of the dog inside and stuff yet?
I think Maddie has that right now.
Okay. So there's a lot of work you can do, not at the park, but up and down your driveway. So was it beast mode?
Mm-hmm.
So beast mode. So go up and down your driveway. Don't be in a rush to, like, the park is the most extreme circumstance. Start it in a low impact circumstance. And in other words, low distractions. Low distractions. Next.
Elizabeth, thanks, Jeff and Joelle, for all you do. So excited for the Florida seminar.
I'm excited, too. And then you can go to jeffgelmanseminars.com, jeffgelmanseminars.com. And if you've got a problem dog, it is a fantastic seminar series to go to. We're doing 28 seminars this year. This is our sixth year or fifth year? This might be our sixth year of seminars. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm new to this world.
Mm-hmm.
Gretchen, I've thought about potentially opening my own service dog facility that allows and encourages corrections in the future. I don't see many companies that allow it, but I don't know that I want to own my own business.
Owning your own business, you're not a dog trainer, you're a business owner. I'd suggest working for somebody else to start. Next.
Melissa posted the link to the raw feeding ebook.
Oh, thank you, Melissa. Great book, guys. Great book. Next.
Blessing, if a dog is off leash trained, couldn't that be used as a form of restraint? I know while working as my service dog, it is, but how about just off duty at a park?
What's the question? I mean, technically, your dog's under voice control, and the remote collar is the backup. Next.
Michael, thanks for all the advice. Stay strong. How quickly do I introduce new ideas and obedience to a 10-week-old puppy?
Ooh.
So far, sit, and he's doing well with kennel. What's next?
Okay, so thank you for the kind words. So with sit, what you can do is, first of all, what I would do is this. Use the dog's daily kibble. All it is just take their kibble, put it in a bag. And so the dog gets, say, 1.5 cups. So all day long, you're just doing all kinds of commands. Do recall, sit, lure into a down, do place, kennel up, default weight at the kennel, come back out. Do that, but tons of recall. Tons of recall. Next.
King Midas, what age week to start prong knee collar? 10-week-month-old GSD in crate. Bonked crate, but it whined more.
It's a little bit too young to start any of that stuff. You want to use maybe just rock the crate. A lot of people like, make the crate a wonderful place. Like, what does that look like? A nice bed? Like, that doesn't...
All our board and trains love their crates.
Yeah. Well, we made it
they
suck.
Have a place caught in there and some
yeah,
water.
But we also made it suck to be a jerk in the crate. So what I would do is, it's 10 weeks old. Who's that, Michael? It's 10 weeks old. This
no,
right
that's
here.
King Midas.
Oh, this right here, don't.
I know.
Yep, it's 10 weeks old, and this is the thing. It's going to suck for a little bit. You're going to have some sleepless nights. But try different, like, hitting the top, hitting the side, bonking it. You know, a lot of people will be like, no, teach it quiet and then click and then reward. We clicker train and reward food train dogs too. But I don't want to do that though. I want my dog just to shut up in the crate. Next. And for some weird reason, it works really quick.
Mm. Christine said, I have questions about separation anxiety.
Okay.
What's the question?
So what I want you to do is go to my video. It's an older video, but it still has valuable information. Look up separation anxiety on my YouTube channel and watch that video. Start there. And then come back on Monday's show and ask your questions. I'm going to ask them tonight if you want to. Next.
Gretchen, interesting that Joelle is mostly being parted from the hate. Saw some absolutely crazy dude who's got to be on drugs said he was parting you from his blast because he wasn't sure if you were being brainwashed. Cool.
What is it about people? Do people think I'm like some brainwashing guru?
Right.
I mean, is it ever thought, like, we have 10 employees here.
Yeah.
Like, have people ever thought
that Jeff is an excellent leader of a company and has a great work environment here and employees actually love coming to work and don't want to leave?
Or have they ever thought that we actually do a good job training dogs?
Yeah.
Has that ever crossed anybody's mind?
Right.
That we actually are a legitimate company.
With an amazing clientele who are actually like family to us.
And we're doing great work with them. Has it ever crossed anybody's mind? It has on a lot of people. But I think when you're just so far removed, like to even to come up with that concept, it just shows you how out of it you really are. Yeah. And it's like time to get out of the basement and to like experience the real world.
Right.
And like, it might be time. Yeah. I mean, it's real. That's an interesting concept. Yeah. Next.
$5 top chat from Paraz. Can't get GSD to stop licking female pee and drool on walks. Afraid he may catch something.
Yeah.
Tried prong and e-collar corrections and nothing works.
Well, if you used a remote collar correction that made it suck to lick pee, it would stop. So I got a feeling you're underwhelming your dog. I don't know enough about the medical, but I imagine licking another's dog's bodily fluids cannot be the healthiest thing. Next.
Barista boy. Yeah, I feel like the haters don't even care about the dog or the training when they do stuff like that. It's just because they're drowning in their own insecurities, and I too genuinely feel bad for them.
Yeah, I mean, I think historically the definite general psychological makeup of somebody that has so much anger and hate inside them is usually low self-esteem, low self-worth. They've experienced some sort of trauma in their life, and they've got lots of insecurities, and they're doing this to feel better. They're also feeling that they're actually making the world a better place, and that justifies it. Also, a lot of people are sheep-like, and what they want to do is they're like, I'm trying to grow my wings, so let me hate on this whatever, and that will justify any of my faults that I've done in my life.
Right.
Instead of doing self-improvement, mm-hmm. So instead of doing self-improvement to make yourself better from the inside, let me make everybody else terrible. So I don't look so bad.
Yeah.
Like that's the dichotomy. That's the wrong word.
No.
Okay.
Philosophy.
That's the mentality of what the hater actually is. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like all these people with all their threats. It's like my company address is public. You don't want to come here because like between security systems and the police, they're fully aware and they're not really big key on like threats. Like everybody in the city of Providence that belongs to the Providence police is very aware of the situation and they are taking it very seriously. The FBI is taking it very seriously. So we don't quite have sniper's nests on the roof, but like we're a legitimate, tax-paying, licensed, controlled by the state of Rhode Island business, and they don't like what's going on. Mm-hmm. They're not thrilled with what's going on. They're happy with me. They're not thrilled with all this law breaking. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there are laws in place,
right?
You know, that do protect citizens. So next.
Nelza eats. Jeff, is it normal for me to have to be at level 50 for a shot collar? My dog is not adapting to his bark collar. I don't even know what I'm doing wrong, but I feel it should have gotten better and it's not.
Well, this is it. Fit is important. So if you've got a long haired dog, you might have to, first of all, it has to be snug. Also, I don't know what brand you're using. Next.
RJ, girlfriend's pit bull attacked my 3-year-old. I stomped that dog half to death. After that, he was the best dog we had.
Hmm. Okay, so 3-year-old child. Oh yeah.
My God.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. You know what? And you know what? I'm sure people will call you a horrific human being. But you know, the bottom line is this, is that a dog is attacking a child. I'd like to think your average rational human being would do a serious consequence. Mm-hmm. I'll leave that up to you. A serious consequence, not pulling it off and putting it in its crate and telling it bad dog, but a serious consequence, which probably does involve discomfort, to let that dog know that is an extremely bad thing to do.
Yeah.
And you want that consequence, which is called an inhibitor, to last for a very long period of time. Until you've taught that dog that, the dog does not know. It is a dog.
Right. You can't just have a conversation with it like a human
right.
being.
Right. You can't have rational conversations with animals. Oh, sure you can. There are people that talk to animals. Okay. You just wasted $4.99 a minute. Okay? It's like, it doesn't work that way. No, it's called cause and effect. Cause and effect. Next.
CT Vader, my third live show. You guys are great. Learned so much from you guys. Since most of us do training in our home, should we be practicing in every room?
For which command?
Any command.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Yeah, as many environmentals as possible. Next.
Gretchen, LOL, I'd never shoot a gun at someone. Really? What if you're in the military and you're deployed in Iraq? You might want one then. Well, in that case, yes, in that case, exactly.
What if somebody breaks into your house?
Right.
What if somebody...
The list goes on.
Yeah. What if you come home and you see somebody attacking your spouse? What if you come home, go to tell your children good night, and there's somebody attacking and assaulting your child, and you have a weapon? I mean, not to be sexist, but we've got being a fucking real man, and then we also have mama bear shit. It's like, you won't make it out of this house alive. And I'm not a violent person, but it's like...
Kids?
It's like, really? You would never shoot somebody? Really? I would. To protect myself. To protect my family.
Context.
To protect my staff.
Yeah.
To protect a loved one. To defend myself. To do my job. If it involved the use of weapons, of course I would. Like, that's the job. But also, it's like context. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, I would never punch somebody. It's like...
Like, never. Like, that's such like
never. It's like...
Be all, end all. Like, never. Wow,
that scares me.
That is scary, to put such limits on things.
Right. That's really, really scary.
Yeah.
Never? Okay. That doesn't mean I'm an advocate for violence, but I'm saying it's like, how about you're being violent? Oh, you shouldn't use violence for violence. Okay. I feel sorry then for the person in your family that's being attacked by somebody that's being violent.
Right.
Like, fucked. Okay. I mean, it's like, you know, we've got to be rational here. Next.
$9.99 top chap. Holding on, dog training. Perfect. That's exactly what I did. You know why? I'm a what would Jeff do soldier. LOL. Advice for haters. Go pull a dog from the shelter and rehab it. Put your energy to good work. J&J 100% behind you.
That's also a good point. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, get a really, really struggling dog. You know, get a really struggling dog. And you know, if somebody wants to say, well, I did it and I spent 2 years and turned into a good dog. Good on you. But could it have been done in 4 months? 2 months, 3 months. Mm-hmm. More time doesn't mean more angel wings. More time means possibly kept the dog in stress for longer. You know, next.
Sarah Bug Art. My grandfather had a husky that attacked many people, including myself, and I wish your methods could have been used on that dog. In the end, he was put down.
Yep. And I'm sorry, but to me, when it comes to a dog attacking other people, there sort of is no rules. I'm sorry. I mean, people have a hard time grasping these concepts, and I'm not going to fucking run from them. No. If I truly want to keep that husky alive, I'm going to do whatever it takes to make sure you don't bite again. And I'm sorry, but rewarding the dog for not biting and for rewarding the dog for making good choices is only part of the equation. Making bad choices really, really suck is the other part of the equation. It's just the way it is. Or you end up with a dead dog. And there are absolutely people out there who feel...
I think that's the better option.
Death before discomfort.
Yeah.
There are people out there that feel that... Do you know that resource guarding? A dog that, like, you put your hand by its food bowl and it growls? They'll put that dog down and rehome it. And that's fine if you've done it. I'm not passing judgment on you. But it's like, that can be fixed in seconds.
Mm-hmm.
Seconds. Forever? Well, what is forever other than death? But for a really long fucking period of time. You fix it, you repeat it, you mark it with a word, you give it a command, and yes, forever. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. Next.
Keeps them out of shelters. Keeps them alive.
Yep. Keeps them alive. That's for sure.
JF, $10 top chat.
Thank you. Thanks for all the top chat, guys.
Hi, you've been a big help with your content about training dogs. How can we stop our dog from destroying the crate when we leave him unsupervised?
That's a hard one to do because it's unsupervised. What I would do, number one, is secure the hell out of that crate. The downfall of having a really secure crate, though, is teeth damage. That's the downfall. But historically, what we also find is when dogs can't, there's no wiggle room for the crate. So if you get a really, really good, strong crate, they stop. There's always going to be a percentage of dogs, though, that don't care, and you'll come home to a bloody mess, which really, really sucks. We work with those dogs. So what you do is remote collar on the dog, get a nanny cam, or like Skype yourself or FaceTime yourself, watch the dog. Usually a nanny cam for under $100 from Amazon is worth it. I mean, it's about the same price as a good crate, so you might as well get a nanny cam. And what you do is you wait for the dog to start mouthing the crate, and you correct it. So when you start doing it, we do this all the time at our seminars. So all of a sudden, next thing you know, the dog just lies down. But you're right. What do you do when you're not home? Next.
$5 top chat from Paraz. What's the best way to calm an overexcited dog when guests come over? Bonk, yep. Make it suck with e-collar, or leash control correction over friendly dog?
Believe it or not, bonking is a great way to get rid of arousal as well. So no, bonk, arousal's down. Great. Step one. Now step two, tell the dog what to do. Next.
Gretchen said, special cases call for special reactions.
Yeah, and we deal with mostly special cases. Almost every, okay. I can only remember maybe 6 to 8 dogs in 2019 out of hundreds that were actually like not special cases.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is, I don't mean that no disrespect for the other dogs, but it's like we've only worked with a half a dozen and 8 dogs that are sort of like on the normal learning curve spectrum, no major behavioral issues, happy-go-lucky, you know, enthused to work, plenty of drive, they'll take food,
never been in a dog fight.
Yep, exactly. But most of the dogs we work with are very, very difficult, challenging dogs. And every dog, literally hundreds of hours of active training are put into these dogs on our watch. Hundreds. So much work is put into them. Next.
Kibu, should I give a treat reward when Kibu ignores a reactive dog or ignores another dog on the walk?
Okay, if you've already told, yeah, Kibu, you've told not to be a dick. So yes. So what happens is step one, which is what a lot of people see me do a lot of, that's like the bonking. That's step one. But that's usually one and done. Every once in a while, you got to do it 2 times, maybe 3 times. But then after that, hundreds of times, you're marking and rewarding the proper behavior. Next.
Barking Bakers, love this response for the puppy crying in the crate. Great explanation on how to deal with them.
Oh, you're welcome, Barking Bakers. You're welcome.
Gretchen, you mentioned the bad roads. Ours were so bad today, I couldn't go to work.
Wow. Yeah. Really? Yeah. I guess we're getting like a bunch of snowstorm in the Northeast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know who I am. Hey, following up with a Maltipoo and Shepherd.
Is that the name of the person?
Yeah.
Oh.
My Maltipoo has actually bitten my GSD once already, and he still tries to go after him. He's gotten a little better, but I don't think it's play.
So now it's time for you to say no and bonk the Maltipoo. Okay? No, bonk, or remote collar. Yeah, so unfortunately, your German Shepherd is not giving your dog a quick nip. So you've got to be the one that does that. But don't bite your dog, please. Next,
Gretchen. Oh, we've had a huge number of accidents on our corner. That's why we always go still when we hear screeching. One time, a lady died. One February, I magically heard a car flip outside.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Julia's Gallery. Just thought I'd drop in to say hi. Hi, guys.
Mm. Thank you so much. Hi. Hello. How are you?
Hello. Gretchen, the number of accidents we've had out here, let's just say I see a ton of roadkill all year long, cats included.
Yeah, I know.
Nelza Eats, Jeff, my dog is turning 10 months. Would you say he's the age that habits get worse, or do I still have time to mold him into a dog that doesn't bark excessively?
12 months of age?
10.
Tell you can just stop that with a bark collar. Bark collar, remote collar, no, boom, correct. Or the bark collar works automatically, bark, consequence, next.
Julie's Canine Academy. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. I'm watching you while I pump. Hi, Julie.
If anybody's wondering what that means, Julie just had a baby. I imagine she's pumping her milk next.
Yeah, remember the clip where you're like, I'll show you how. Remember? And I was like dying at her house.
Okay.
Dying. That was when he was like newly born.
Don't make me look like I can pump milk better than a female.
She was going to buy like one of those little things. Like, let me show you how to get that baby on the boob.
After seven kids, she was having a very rough. And we've got Providence, Rhode Island, Hasbro Children's Hospital has got a great lactation nurses. And a lot of females, most of my clients are female. I deal with a lot of moms. And then Linda's got a lot of mom friends. And I hear her conversations with a lot of her friends that are breastfeeding. And there are a lot of moms that struggle getting the baby to get on the boob. So I've heard a lot. I've seen a lot. I've seen a lot of the tricks. And I've heard all the conversations. So I'm no expert at it at all. I do not claim to be at anything, actually. But there absolutely, I have some tips and some tricks when it comes to a woman if she's struggling with getting the baby on the boob. But nowhere is near as like a lactation expert. But it's like, but I'm standing in the room and maybe my idea works. I show Josh how to quiet the baby down. So he didn't
know. I'm giving you credit. Yeah, I know. You know your shit with babies.
No. I'm not saying you're not, but I'm just saying, though, it's like, you know, that you were making fun of me a little bit with the lactation. Okay.
Whatever. Sarah Bug Art. One more thing on the crate issue. He will stop barking if I'm in sight. He stops.
Of course.
If I say no so he can hear, then go bonk or shake the crate.
Yes. No first and then consequence. Okay. You can say no, and obviously you can say yes or no. Deliver your food reward a little bit later and deliver your punisher a little bit later. But your marker of yes and no, the yes is when you do exactly what I want. The no is when you do what I don't want. And then you have a little bit of time to apply either your reward or your punisher next.
That's the beauty of markers.
Yeah, that's why we talk about markers.
It buys you time.
Right, right.
Tim, J&J, you're both great trainers. I learned a lot from the both of you. Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much.
C. Tierman, hi. Any advice on licensing a training business? Looking for an insurance company recommendation.
I don't know what state you're in, and I wouldn't make a recommendation. As far as licensing, just go to your Secretary of State. Go to your Secretary of State and talk to them, and they'll be able to walk you through. You don't even have to go to them. Just go to their website, which is usually like ri.state.gov or something like that, you know? So whatever state you're in. Next.
Gretchen, by the way, I quit my job one more week and I'm out of that toxic environment.
Awesome.
Children will probably drain me too, though, with the new child watch job.
Oh, yeah. Jeez, I don't know which one's worse there, Gretch. Next.
Barking Bakers. Thank you. We actually bought Hotwire, getting ready to install. Thank you for your response. I appreciate your time and all your help and advice.
Yeah, Hotwire is, I mean, it sounds like, oh my God, you're shocking the dog. It's like, yeah, but the dog's trying to break out of the, dig out of the bottom of the crate.
Why is it okay to use for cattle? But not dogs.
Because they're dogs. Dogs get a free pass on every bad behavior there is, including biting. No harm should ever come to them.
Yep.
That's the philosophy. They're man's best friend. They'll do anything to make you happy. That's the philosophy, which I disagree with.
Yeah.
I believe that a lot of dogs are just selfish. They do things for their own self-fulfilling prophecy. And they're doing it because there's something in it for them. Mm-hmm. Now, God, who is...
I know, it's Wes. God. I'm so...
Did you feed deer tonight? That is such an identifiable deer fart. That is like so, like...
It's so bad.
It's like, that is... You know,
he ate it for breakfast.
Do you know that like the other night I wanted to pass out on the couch and just fall asleep on the couch? And I'm like, now I'm saying to myself after smelling that fart... And then I was with Angelo, and Angelo's like, yeah, Papa, we can sleep here. And I'm like, Ange, if anybody doesn't know, Angelo is my 7-year-old son. I homeschool him, and you see him in a lot of our videos. And he has his own Instagram channel, and he's starting his own Twitch channel, and he's going to be a YouTuber. And that's the part that really bothers me, that people are picking on him too.
Yeah.
And with all this hate, it's like, you're picking on it. You know, you're literally picking on a 7-year-old child. Like, what kind of human being are you? You know, you don't like fine. You don't like that I'm throwing a towel at a dog. Fine, okay, I get it. But picking on a 7-year-old child, I don't think that gets anybody a free pass on that one. Next.
Frank, I have a perfect leash heel, except head always far forward in front of my leg. Leash pops backward, works for seconds, then creeps forward.
Yep.
Constant pops with the same result. How to fix this?
You're nagging your dog. Watch my video on the 180, the real 180. It's a pretty invasive move, but guess what? It works. Also, there's spatial pressure. Did you contact Maddie and ask her if there's enough footage for you to show a good spatial pressure? I think there is, because there's two dogs you work with, and one of them was doing some great disengagement. It might have been the first one you worked with for that reactive dog class.
I haven't looked through any of it, but
yeah, I watched you do it, so I think there is. Hmm. We have to ask Bronwyn if she...
Yeah, was she filming? That's the question.
Excuse me, if she filmed it or not. Next.
Kyle, hey guys, thank you for all the great content. Is it dangerous to leave the prong collar on while playing off-leash long-distance fetch in the park?
No, except if there's chain link fence close by. Or another dog. Next.
Gretchen, oh hey, you mentioned trained trolls. Just FYI, yes, some people start up trouble just to watch the drama and laugh.
Yeah.
No exaggeration. Search YouTube for videos where people talk about the drama.
No, I know. Trust me, I know. I've got the CIA handbook. Next. Mm-hmm.
Jenny C., that's infuriating. Tried positive training for months, and I found y'all after a lengthy YouTube search, and everything is better. I'm about to do a chonkla spoof and make that viral to drown out the hate, lol.
Yeah. So isn't it incredible how we hear that story thousands of times?
Right.
Thousands of times saying, I've tried so much training. Mm-hmm. I've been shamed by my trainer for being lazy. I've gone through 5 trainers. I saw one of your videos. And in that one video, that did better than 5 other trainers could do. We just got an email that someone spent $8,000 and they watched one of our videos and they got better results. And the video is free. That's why it's so funny.
It's so wild.
It's so funny when people are like, and you're a money-grubbing guy. It's like...
Taking people's money.
Taking people's money.
Taking it.
It's like...
Voluntary transaction business.
I'm in the voluntary transaction business and for some reason, people still keep coming to us. You know? Yeah. It's an interesting mindset. Next.
Kara... I've noticed a difference with popping my dog backwards and walking into her as soon as she's reactive. It's funny because I did the same with my horse when she was acting a fool in public.
Bingo.
Hmm.
Bingo. That's the spatial pressure exercise. Yep. Yes.
Gretchen, sometimes people start huge fights over whether it's possible to do XYZ while doing something, and it starts out small, and then people actually get riled up, and they just sit back and eat popcorn.
Yep, I know.
Kara, once I get my dog to a point where she seems nervous and not knowing what to expect when near other dogs, what do I do? Will she eventually relax? I tend to ignore her and the other dog. I just keep walking.
Yeah, so if you keep leading, your dog will acclimate and start relaxing, yes.
Anna and Alicia, she has improved with some e-collar in correcting one of our chihuahuas has snapped at her and tried going after her because of our Great Dane was all over her and overly excited. Thank you for the tips.
You're welcome.
Ryan, hi, I recently rescued a pit bull. She whines and lunges at other dogs when passing. Are these signs of aggression or simply wanting to play?
I don't know. I'm not there. I don't know. It could be both. Both can be both. Your dog can have both. The most leash reactive dog I've ever worked with was a 90-pound Rottweiler, and it looked like it wanted to kill another dog, and it went to daycare every day.
Yep.
So you don't know. I'm not there. I'd have to see video, and I guess we'd have to drop the leash and shoot, see what happened. Please don't do that. Next.
Don't do that.
Next.
Oh my God.
So much for the 1-hour show.
I know. Sid. Hi, J&J. My GSD is jealous of a dog I'm sitting, and GSD whines and mumbles, barks. I correct or bonk. She stops but does it again. Stubborn. Suggestions?
Correct higher. Next.
Kara, how do I teach large breed dogs to be around small animals without risking a small animal life? I have a cat I want to have in my home, but 2 Danes have killed cats on record. Cat has no claws.
So, oh, shit, that doesn't. The best thing the cat could do is smack it across the face.
Smack it.
So what I would do right now is I would put your dogs into avoidance, meaning if you go even go near the cat, it's going to suck. Next.
Edgar's, hello, guys. I can see that you were coming to the UK. Great. People are already talking about you and your training methods. I'm sick of it. I'm glad that you don't listen to them. Have a good time in the UK.
Yeah, just thank you so much, but just... We love the UK. I had the best. I've been to Scotland before. I mean, I've done these seminars before. Like, we travel the world. Scotland is a beautiful country, and England is a beautiful country, but I really enjoyed Scotland a lot. I saw more of... The reason why I saw more of Scotland, and I saw all the little wee villages.
The wee villages?
And And I saw England. I think Scotland, I was more... Scotland, I was more in the country, and I really appreciated that, the greenery. England, I was more in the city, and I liked that a lot, too. So I saw a nice little mixture of it as well. And these aren't my methods. These are well-practiced methods. Just for an FYI, guys, hundreds of established dog trainers bonk. Hundreds. And tens of thousands of owners, if not hundreds of thousands. There's 250 million dogs in the U.S. 1% of that is what? 2.5 million. So a large amount of dogs have had shit thrown at it to stop bad behavior. Next.
A Beck Gallia, hi J&J. Struggling to hear missed podcasts on Apple Podcasts. I've tried going through the link on your site, but no success. Any ideas? Thank you for all you do.
I think Melissa answered that question for you. I think she put a link up. And then, Melissa, can you contact Amanda and have Amanda fix that? Or if that's on your end, next.
Mothman, I've sent chats, but I think they're not showing up. Is the ban on swearing still a thing?
No.
I have not seen any of your questions, Mothman.
No, Mothman, no. You're allowed to swear. Fuck. It came through, right? You guys heard, fuck.
Shit. It starts, like, censoring you. Shit. It's like, boop, shit, boop, piss. Boop.
Yeah. No, your question might be too long. I know what happens with YouTube is if the question's too long, it bounces it out. Next.
Kara, I have a hard time taking my dog out in public sometimes. She has a really good public access, but people won't ever shut up about her. Everyone wants to touch, give commands, give treats. God.
So what's her name? Kara?
Yep.
Kara, have better boundaries. So Kara, you have a boundary issue. Learn how to say no. You can always be polite at the get-go. Thank you for asking, but no. And then if they're not polite, what you can do is now you have to go get the fuck away from my dog. But always start out polite. Next.
Nia, thank you, Jeff and Joelle, for all your free content. Can't wait to see you guys in Atlanta this April.
Yeah, Atlanta's going to be fun.
Hot Atlanta.
It's going to be a good time.
Look at those oysters again. Ugh. Those are really good.
What was the name of that place?
I don't know. It was so good, though. Barbara will know.
Barbara knows all the good food. Her house is done, too.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I can't wait to see it.
You know, we should have her cook for us. Her shit looks amazing.
Yeah, fuck that. We should go to Barbara's house every night for dinner.
Kara, it's constant, and it gives me anxiety having these people constantly coming up to me. I wish people would just mind their own business.
Okay, so who's that?
Kara.
Kara? Okay. This is what you got to do. You need to have boundaries. I already mentioned this, the boundaries. You need to stand your ground, and I assure you, they'll stop. You need to walk around, not with resting bitch face, and I don't say that because you're a female, like dudes can have it too, but you need to project yourself as somebody who doesn't want them to pet their dog. Project yourself. Yeah. Got it? Walk with a mission. So remember maybe in high school or college when you walked with your back hunched holding your books like this, all right? Or you walked like this. Like a badass. There's great studies out there for, I'm not even going to talk about sexual predators. Let's talk about pickpockets. And they'll show a crowd scene and they'll be able to target who they pickpocket. Next.
Janine. Hi, I have a 2-year-old lab pit becoming aggressive and growling, snapping. Also bit neighbor and myself. Advice.
Advice on the podcast for that is going to be really challenging. Number one, keep it on a leash, keep it away from the neighbor for now. I don't know what the context is of when it bit you. I would need a lot more context. Whenever it comes to biting dogs, that is our specialty. That's going to be a Skype session for you, though. Next.
Elizabeth, do you have a video that demonstrates when a dog is loading and about to react?
You gotcha.
Yeah, we get a really good tons. One from that Petaluma seminar.
Tons of them. Mm-hmm. That's when we bonk. That's what all the controversy is over. It's like for people to say it's like, oh my God, you hit this white, fluffy, innocent dog.
And it was doing nothing.
And it was doing nothing but wagging its tail, looking at its owner. It's like you do realize that dog drags its owner out of her wheelchair and makes her fall flat on her face.
But not even that. It's the loading phase. Nobody's picking
up. The dog was loading. loading is staring at another dog. It did look at its owner because she said no. But if you really watch the video, I mean, I explained the video. So in the description of this podcast, where it says, in the description box where it says, what would Jeff do show, number 690, whatever we're on, right below that, it gives you a hot link, a YouTube link. That's to the video. Click on the video after the show. You will see, you don't see the best example of loading. The best example of loading is that white dog in the muzzle that we have a video on. Or the one with the bicycle. Mm-hmm. That's loading. Yeah. Loading is like staring with intent to do something bad. Next.
Kara, sometimes people get worked up and I have to correct her over and over trying to get her to calm down.
Use a bonker next time. Next.
Kibu, FYI, check out activated charcoal for dogs and possible concerns when dog licks pee, etc. I use it all the time if Kibu licks the grass and not sure what he got into. It absorbs all the toxins.
Yes.
Interesting.
Interesting.
Nelza, hi Jeff, maybe that's the problem. He's a toy poodle and the collar is called Pet Trainer. I bought it off Amazon.
Yeah, I would get rid of that shit collar. Get a microeducator. Next.
Three parts. Ready? Alexa. Hey, I have a dog I'm working with that gets really scared when learning new things. When we realize we want him to do something different, he shakes and backs away. He's learned a few things since we got him, but it takes forever. Any confidence building tips? We rescued him at 3, so I think he has a bad training history.
Well, no, not necessarily. It could be genetic. I mean, what I want you to do is this. Let's forget about if the dog has a bad history or not. Let's just like start from scratch. And let's just do this. You've got a nervous, fearful dog. In fact, I just did a thing on that. Lead the dog. Show the dog what it can and cannot do. But don't show it what it can't do. It can do anything, just about within reason. But lead the dog. Get through the messy middle. That's called the messy middle. Next. So as far as confidence building things, you know, climbing up on things, going under things, going through things, even like getting up on like a little step stool is like confidence building. Next.
Melissa, thank you for being so real about dealing with aggressive dogs and people. This is a conversation that a lot of people shy away from.
Yeah, many people do. And it has to be said. Dogs are dying. Next.
Colorado girl said, why don't they just go watch something else instead of being nasty?
Well, because I think that it goes back to that whole self-worth thing where they feel that like they're it feels like they're helping. And a lot of them are just making up for their sins of their past. They really are. A lot of them are making up for their sins of their past. Next.
Andrew. Jeff, I asked a question last week and missed the answer. We have a 3-year-old Dogo, sweet dog, but she still pees in the house. Can you give us a good tip to stop this behavior?
I'm not the pee guy necessarily. I mean, when I lived in, I think I remember answering the show because I made a joke about living in Amsterdam for 2 years, which I never did. That's the joke. And it's, you said, what is that called? The golden shower. And I'm like, well, it depends if,
how about. Yes, like we don't have to replay the whole thing.
So I gave the answer. I said, what I would do is I would put the dog on a regular routine and no free watering. And then also no free roaming. Next.
Daniel, hi, how are you today?
Oh, Daniel, I'm doing, sorry, I thought there was going to be a question. That is the question. I'm doing fantastic. Thank you.
Let's see. Hannah, I have 2 dogs. One has gone blind but hasn't needed enucleation. Dog 2 doesn't understand and wants to play rough like they used to. The blind dog has become angry and fights back fearfully. Suggestions?
What I would do is you've got to, unfortunately, even blind dogs can fight, but it might be uncertain. What you want to do is stop the second dog from being so, I don't want to say the word aggressive, but such a hard player. Next.
Jenny, any word on the Denver seminar if you found a location?
No, I haven't found a location yet for Denver or Phoenix yet. Next.
Julie said, like a cow with a laughing emojis.
Oh, so Julie's talking about pumping. I know. Pumping. I was going to tell a mastitis story, but I can't. It's too personal. Not on me. I didn't get mastitis, you know. Wouldn't that be funny? I did get pregnancy weight, though. So.
Yeah. I hear that's a thing. You eat all the snacks, too, right? I want ice cream. And it's like, do you want some?
I don't know. I don't think it was quite that bad. Yeah. Next.
Grace, in a park with my service dog and was rushed by two off-leash Goldens. I heard, "It's okay, they're friendly," as they jumped on us. I went to the ground and my service dog down. Sadly, he missed an alert. Not that I could have expected him to focus during that. Just glad he stayed obedient during the hell of a distraction.
Yeah, unfortunately, you know, guys, having your friendly dogs off-leash, unless they've got really good recall, please don't have them off-leash. Next. Couple more questions, then we got to close the show out.
Gretchen said, someone told me when the dog jumps, it meets the top of his hat because he whacks him with it. Made me smile. People bonk and don't even know there's a word or known method for it. Yeah, right. No shit. Amber, hi, my 10-month-old husky is frightened of literally everything, both outside and inside. Should I use the prong collar on her during walks, or will it make her more nervous?
No, it won't make her more nervous. You'll hear that it will. Like, this is the conversation out there that's a lie. Oh, so you're going to inflict pain on your already nervous dog? Like that, it's like, who says anything about inflicting pain? Well, that's why it works. It's like, no, no. Why does clicker and food work? Because it's painful? No. Like, these are just the ridiculous discussions. It's all dog training, man. It's all called dog training. All right, last question of the night.
All right. Edgar's best way to introduce 10-month-old Mally to 2-year-old Mal. Both are males, getting a second Mal, so need advice. LOL, maybe not the best idea, but maybe you have some advice. Thank you.
It's not the best idea. There's your advice. Who said that?
That was Edgar's.
Edgar's. Thank you, Edgar's, for the question. So, 2 males? What are you, crazy? So what I want you to do is this. I don't know your skill set. I don't know the male's temperaments at all. What I would do is I would start thinking about running your house like a kennel, though. Massive amounts of structure. A lot of get them to be able to go from drive to no drive. 10-month-old dog is going to be on the cusp of sexual maturity, so anything could happen. Anything could happen. The best way to do it is this. Don't go in with the mindset that you want them to be friends. Go into the mindset that you don't want a dog fight, which is sort of an interesting way to go into it. It's like, I just don't want a dog fight. Let's see how they organically, like, grow. But I love multiple dogs. I love multiple dogs. So I run a pack of 3 dogs. I've had up to 12, but I'm really comfortable with a pack of 3. I own 4, but Max stays at home because he lives in the front yard.
Bert and Wes are, like, part of the pack.
Yeah, actually, that's true. So, but, yeah, I do run a pack of 5, I guess. But, so what I do is, but even Wes, like, Wes, you know, he's just coming around to actually getting very friendly with my dogs. At the beginning, though, the plan was just don't attack them.
It's been like, God, almost over a solid year now, right?
They get along great. They like bump into each other.
Oh, yeah, but it took a long time
for him
to want to play.
Right, correct. They
he existed.
Bingo. He was very hesitant to get into the back of my truck for a very long period of time. Mm-hmm. Which is good, actually, by the way. It's like, good. I'm glad you're hesitant to...
Oh, he went from chasing dogs down from 100 yards away right. and putting them in the hospital to, I'm going to get in the truck.
I'm going to get in the truck. So, but now they like, you know, girl will play bite him on the back of the neck.
He thinks it's great.
Yeah, and the other day at the park, at the power lines, they were like chasing each other. You got some good video of that, too. Mm-hmm. Got some good video of that, too. So anyway, we've got to end out the show. We do have to stop at some time, and we do have to stop an hour and a half into the show because we still have work to do. I'm madly in love with you. We'll be back on the air on Monday, the 8th of the 8th at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Monday night. All of this can be seen on YouTube, by the way. And I really appreciate all of you, and I love all of you. And don't forget JeffGellmanSeminars.com, JeffGellmanSeminars.com. Buy your tickets. The seminar schedule is there for everybody to see. All right? Madly in love with you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Wish we can go longer, but we can't. We really can't.